If you buy a large air pump, the included manifold often looks like this. If you connect it to many hydroponic systems or aquariums, you will need several long air tubes. The result will be messy and look something like this. All the tubes have to go all the way back to the pump. The small air tubes will also bend easily and stop the airflow. A much better solution is a larger main airline with branch offs for each of the hydroponic systems or aquariums. However, it can be hard to find the parts to build an air distribution system like this. In this video, we will show you how to build an air distribution system using standard water irrigation ports. First, we will take a look at two popular large air pumps and the included manifolds. This is the Boyu SES-20 and the SES-30. The pumps comes with a manual, a short 8mm tube, a manifold, and a brass connector. The pump has an aluminium cover and feels very solid. The brass connector is 8mm and is screwed to the pump. The connector fits well with the included 8mm tube. The included manifold has 6 exits and also fits well with the tubing. The included manifold for the SES-20 looks okay, but you will still need to stretch 6 airlines back to one central location, like we explained earlier. Now let's have a look at the SES-30. The SES-30 is even more powerful. It pumps 1800 liters per hour and is 25 watts. While the SES-20 pumps 1200 liters per hour and is 15 watts. This is the included pump connector for the SES-30. It is much bigger than the SES-20. But as you can see, the manifold and tube looks identical. Fitting the connector to the tube will be very hard, and you would probably have to warm up the tubing in hot water. Also, the SES-30 is much more powerful than the SES-20, so the included manifold should have more exits than the SES-20. I'm really not sure what the manufacturer was thinking here. Let's make our own air distribution system. The pump connector for the SES-30 is 13mm, so we will use a flexi-tube with 12mm inner diameter. This will be our main airline. We will make a short main airline since this is just a small demonstration system. It fits much better than the included tubing. We secure the tube with a hose clamp. You can also use zip ties. Next, we'll use these lock nut fittings. You could also use barb fittings shown to the left. We think these fittings are a bit more secure than the barbed ones, since they are locked in place with the nut. We will make one more manifold on the main airline. You can of course make as many as you like. This is a manifold with two exits. The previous one had four exits. Again, this is just for demonstration. You should make the length and number of exits fit your grow room or fish tank room. After you have made as many exits as you need, fit an end connector to the end. This is our finished sample, let's try it. We place the pump higher than the water level so we don't have to use check valves. Let's connect all the 4mm air tubes. Okay, let's turn on the power and see how it works. As you can see, this pump is capable of running much more than 6 air stones. With this setup, you can easily extend the main air line with more brown shafts at any time. But this is as much as we could fit in our test setup. The pump runs silently for such a large pump and it is very powerful. Too bad they made such a bad manifold for such a good pump. But if you build your own, you can tailor it to your needs and make a tidy air distribution system. Good luck and have fun. We will include links to all the parts we used in this video in the description. Thank you.